innovation. It's been our lifeblood for 125 years.
Innovation is not only essential for our survival, but it's essential for our long-term success.
From the day in 1867, when George Herman Babcock and Stephen Wilcox patented the world's first non-explosive boiler, from the moment 125 years ago today, when they established our British company, our name has changed, but our ability to scan the horizon remains to this day.
To work for a company that's been around for 125 years, it fills me with a sense of pride.
It's good to see so many successes were achieved, but also to think about what you can do next.
From steam to steel, over land and sea, the story of Doosan Babcock's first half century is one of constant innovation. But it's also about the communities where we've made our home.
Whoever had the foresight to invest in Scotland and in the UK in the skills that were available at that time over 100 years ago had incredible foresight of what they were actually investing in.
A Babcock's boiler was second to none. The boilers that we built, you could put a cathedral in the furnace. The steam drum could be 90 tonnes. And that was manufactured in Renfrew. A large part of Renfrew's population worked in Babcock's.
Here she comes, the holiday special to take B&W families for their holidays at Blackpool and Morecambe.
They had a holiday club, and they would go down to hotels in Blackpool, Morecambe, Scarborough, have the holidays with their workmates, and then come back.
Oh, you'll have a quiet time, you people left behind, with half Renfrew heading for Blackpool and the sea.
Cumberland. At Calder Hall, Britain is shaping her industrial future by the building of an atomic power station, the first of its kind in the world. On this site will be created the driving force for industry and light, heat and warmth for the home. Among equipment being unloaded are boilers for the nuclear reactors. For even in this atomic age, steam will power the giant turbines and so produce electricity for the national grid.
We were proud of Calder Hall, first nuclear power station. And from there, we developed onto AGRs, which advanced gas-cooled reactors.
We had a very insightful director who decided that we should be in nuclear engineering. That was a big milestone.
The Queen visited in 1966, and they had an open Land Rover, and the Queen stood in that Land Rover with the Duke of Edinburgh, and the Land Rover went through all the manufacturing shops. Now, at that time, no one wore hard hats. They all wore caps, and for the first time in my life, as the Queen drove through the shops, they removed their caps.
My name is Margaret Laird. I've lived in Knockhill Road, which is adjacent to Babcock's. I lived there all my life. There used to be two horns. One was for all the children, that's what we were told, and that was to get in the house before the second horn, and that's when the gates opened. I'm the seventh of eight lasses, and five is all worked in Babcock's. We worked in the canteen. All the workers come in, they were cheery. There were some faces that you knew that, I don't think they work here, but everybody come in for their lunch.
My name is Maris McLaughlin. I'm a sales manager in the machine shop. I started as an apprentice turner in 1969. There was a football competition, yeah, it was the McLaren Cup. There'd be a team from the machine shop, there'd be a team from the plating shop, team from the fabrication shop. So it was like a sort of a mini European tournament.
There would be Christmas parties for the kids and different things. Santa always arrived.
As the world looked on, enthralled by mankind's latest giant leap, our own forward thinking brought its return in the form of new and growing markets, continuing Doosan Babcock's transformation into a global leader.
I started with the company in July 1986, which means that I have exactly 30 years service in this month. Before I worked with Doosan Babcock, I had worked for other engineering companies, and I guess you become accustomed to a certain size of engineering project. My first day on the Drax Power Station in Yorkshire just opened my eyes to just how big a project this was. I think there was about 750 people working on site at that time, which was big in its own right. But what really impressed me was the size of the engineering components that you were dealing with. It was just so much bigger than anything I had ever seen before.
From engineering to asset management, energy, petrochemicals, pharmaceuticals, process, improving, modernizing, ensuring safety and protecting our planet.
My name is Elena Blinova. I've been in the UK for 4.5 years and I'm working in the Green Power Solutions team doing business development for London. Fuel cells, it's... As some of our clients say, it's a magic box. It's a great, you know, solution product which we have as a part of our strategy towards a low-carbon future.
When I consider the celebration of 125 years, I sometimes think back to what would the original Mr. Babcock and Mr. Wilcox think of where we are today as a company. I'm sure that they would be proud to see that we had survived two world wars in that time, that we have survived some terrible market conditions, but actually to witness that this company that they started is actually growing, developing, branching out into new areas. I think that they would be incredibly proud of where we are today.
Innovating, adapting, diversifying. We've met the challenges of our changing world for well over a century, delivering value for our customers, finding better solutions, expanding from our home in Renfrew to establish a global business. How have we done this? With people.
In the early days of Doosan Babcock, we sold products. A client could look at a sales brochure and pick out products that he wanted to buy. Now, what we sell is know-how. And the know-how is the collective skills of our people. The next 125 years will need some very specialist products. It will need some very specialist business models to meet the specific requirements of our customers. But most of all, we'll need some very special people.
My name's Zach Edge, and I'm currently an apprentice for Doosan Babcock. What attracted me to Doosan was its rich history, basically. It's been around for 125 years now, and it's always been a well-respected company.
We've got a great bunch of people that work in it, very talented people.
Management is good in supporting people.
Everyone gets to voice their opinions on different matters, and whether it's through themselves or through a representative, they all get a chance to have their opinions heard.
Our people also have another objective, to help to build a better world. Year-round, Doosan Babcock staff work within their communities giving their time to help local charities and other good causes.
The Cherry Centre is a community centre. We run a nursery and an after-school care at an affordable price. It's got to be a place where the parents feel that they can leave their kids. And that's where Doosan came in. All these girls and boys all arrived, and it was absolutely fabulous, and they were all happy to be there. The amount of time that they spent cleaning and painting, and we couldn't pay for that kind of work.
For the next 125 years, I think it's quite simple. We have a blueprint in one Doosan Babcock, and we also have the Doosan Credo, and if we follow the traits of that, we'll be, I think, successful.
I think what makes Doosan special is because it's able to adapt to an ever-changing marketplace. As a company, we're able to see what's working and what isn't working.
Doosan Babcock have a tremendous heritage. I feel very proud to have been a small part of that.
From our side as a community, we can't thank them enough for the work that they have done in supporting us.
If Babcock and Doosan can carry on the way Babcock and Wilcox did, all to the good. And I wish them all the very best.
Well done, Doosan Babcock. Live long and prosper.
Congratulations on 125 years of a successful, adaptable business.
On the 125th anniversary, I would like our people to accept my sincere appreciation for all of the work that they've put into the company. I think that we should look back, we should reflect on the 4th of July and think of the millions of man-hours of human effort that have been put into getting us to where we are today. I think we should also look at and respect the workforce that we have at the moment and to work together as one team, one Doosan Babcock. Finally, people need to understand that the future of the company is in their hands. And that's why when we looked at our conference this year, our 2016 conference, the theme was excellence, the future starts with you.
The story of Doosan Babcock is the story of countless people. People across our planet who rise to each new challenge, who find new solutions, who explore new opportunities, who help to build a better world. It is these people, their resourcefulness and ingenuity, that will see us through future challenges. Today, we celebrate 125 years of innovation, of transformation. One, Doosan Babcock.